director. Hello? Anyone here?
Guess not. Seems... than the rest of the bureau.
Thank you.
It's not working. Probably a loose power core somewhere. Should open. But something definitely happened here.
Each other? This feels familiar. I can't seem to... I've forgotten it. I'm sorry. My name is Alan Wake.
Friend Tom. Tom Zane. There's nothing to worry about.
Tom. The poet. The diver, you look different.
That was just a role. A character. The protagonist I played in my old film. I'm a filmmaker. An auteur like yourself. We're working on this together, remember? An artistic collaboration. You need a drink. Ippers.
Endless darkness. Nothing holds still.
But we're very close now. You've been writing. You found a way to escape. It'll work this time.
Writing?
You found a way!
No. I don't... Wait. There's something. It's my double. He's out there. I've seen
him. Yeah. Nothing to worry about. I'm dealing with it. It's fine, my friend. Let me handle him.
You've met him? What the hell?
Now, come on. You misunderstand me.
That was Alan Wake, the writer who went missing in that AWE case I read about. What's he doing here? Thomas Zane was with him. The poet. No, wait. He was a filmmaker. I always remember that wrong.
Dr. Emil Hartman, devoured by hungry darkness, became the thing that had been Hartman. Broke loose, killed everyone it could. Lurking, roaming, waiting. Then something else came. A resonance. The thing that had been Hartman went through another change. Dr. Emil Hartman was desperate. The Federal Bureau of Control had stolen his life's work. This was his last chance, his final experiment, what he'd been too scared to do before. Hartman dove into the lake, was taken, devoured by hungry darkness, became the thing that had been Hartman. Only an echo of him remained, fragmented impulses on autoplay, violent, bloodthirsty darkness in the driver's seat. Emerging from the lake, the thing was captured by the FPC. Brought in, contained, studied. The thing broke loose, killed everyone it could. The FPC fell back and sealed the sector. The thing was alone in the dark, lurking, roaming, waiting. Then something else came. Not darkness, but similar enough. A sound, a resonance. It shouldn't be a surprise. If there's one, why not another? The darkness inside the thing could have been immune, could have resisted, fought, could have been passed by, passed through with no effect. But it didn't, and it wasn't. Maybe it had grown weaker over time, not aged. It was timeless, but weaker with no link to its source. A metamorphosis followed. The thing that had been Hartman went through another change.
creepy, damp, and abandoned. Why did Wake want me to come here? That doesn't look like a house shift. Do I even want to know? Are already in here. Whoa. Looks like the house has gotten a little wild in here. Thank you. This darkness is blocking the door. So now I have to deal with an interdimensional noise and sentient shadows. It away, huh? Makes sense.
Sound made darker, the darkness made louder. Hartman was stretched like a worm through time. The third thing was a monster. Now he crashed out of darkness toward Faden. Resonance carves its way through the thing that had been Hartman, vibrating, remolding. The sound changes the darkness, and the darkness changes the sound. They both changed what remained of Hartman. They all turned into something else. A third thing. The sound made darker. The darkness made louder. Hartman was stretched. Stretched as anyone when seen from out of time, like a worm through time. Almost An Ouroboros. A spiral. A maelstrom. The gravity well of a black hole, twisting inward, tightening, taking you deeper and deeper to the bottom, the heart, and through to the other side. The third thing said, when you hear this, you will know you're a new you. He said, we build you till nothing remains. He said, under the conceptual reality, behind this reality, you must want these ways to drag you away. He said, baby, 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 yeah, orange peel. The third thing was a monster. He'd tear apart any ordinary person crossing his path. Now he crashed out of darkness toward Faden. There was nothing ordinary about Faden.
My understanding of the darkness is fragmented, incomplete. This abyss, this void, it very much does not wish to be understood. If light symbolizes knowledge, then it stands to reason that darkness would equate to ignorance. By its very nature, it abhors comprehension. Of course, my own nature drives me to comprehend all. We are opposing forces, destined to collide. And given this conflict of natures, we know that the light of truth will burn away the darkness, both figuratively and literally. Any significant light source can be used as protection, even weaponry against this metaphysical gloom. And then there are the artists. I know for a fact that Tom, Wake, the Anderson brothers, and Lane all had some involvement with the darkness. The question is whether their uncanny ability to affect reality through their art beckons the darkness, or did their work perhaps even create it? With Wake now secure in my lodge, I expect I shall grow closer to learning the answers to these questions. Assuming he cooperates, which is proving quite the challenge. Well, perseverance is the foundation of knowledge. Speaking of, I must be off on my rounds.
Reminder, all employees are required to report their hours at the end of each month. The Federal Bureau of Control maintains that time is not subjective, and hours passed on alternative planes cannot be claimed. Astral dives do not accumulate overtime compensation. Thank you for your attention.
Six inside the motel. Utilized surveillance methods are as follows. Fiber optic cameras slid under the individual room doors. Motion detectors in the lobby area. Tripwire triggering a flash camera across the main entrance. Even fingerprint powder on the front desk. Results are varying at best. But mostly just inconclusive and unusable. The footage is corrupted. Sometimes even the equipment is damaged. I don't know how exactly. I think this place is making fun of me. That's the only explanation. I can hear them laughing and screaming behind the closed doors. I could hear the call bell going ding multiple times a day, but when I look, there's no one there. I know I'm supposed to stay out of sight, but I've seen the doors closing just before I can catch even a glimpse of anyone or anything. They're messing with me, whoever they are. I think... Wait, shh. There's something. I gotta get this. Gotta get the cable out. Come on, you fiber optic fuck, cooperate. Okay, there we go. All right, that was faint, but I definitely heard movement coming from the hallway. I think I might have finally caught one. Ha! The recording better work this time, or I swear to God, I'm... What? Hello? Who's there? Oh, shit. I'm with the FBC. Move away from the door. I have a... Where's my...
Something in this darkness is draining me.
21 years old, resident of Southern Texas.
I'm sorry, ma'am, but I really don't understand why I'm here.
You know what you did, Mr. Hennerman.
I do?
Tell me about Delivery Disaster.
The movie? It wasn't very good.
That's not what your review said, but we'll come back to that. Tell me where you got the movie from.
Movie night, with a, you know, a K, not an N, not night, like nighttime, but...
Who contacted you? Who told you to review that film?
No one. I just did it because it looked obscure. I didn't even like the movie. I shouldn't have given it such a high score, but reviewing obscure films makes you look smart. And I thought if I looked smart, I would get listeners. My podcast would take off and I could live out of my parents' basement. I may even go to college and get a film degree like I've always wanted to. I swear.
Okay, the kid doesn't know shit. I'm ending the session.
Okay, this room is really intimidating and all, but I know my rights. It's not a crime to try and get a book signed.
Making unauthorized contact with a dangerous paranormal entity is indeed a bureau offense, Mr. Langston, and can be prosecuted as such.
Okay. Well, I didn't know that. Listen, this is being blown way out of proportion. All that happened is I heard Dr. Hartman had been brought in and... Since I'm a huge Alan Wake fan, I thought it'd be cool to get a copy of The Creator's Dilemma signed. That's a book that Hartman wrote about...
We know what it is.
Okay. Good. So yeah, I was just looking to fill out my Wake collection. I certainly didn't know Hartman had turned into some kind of shadow zombie.
That's a completely inaccurate description.
Whatever. Listen, I'm just a desk jockey. I sort papers, do data entry, that kind of stuff. Don't come down on me like this. I made one mistake. I mean, I see people break the rules all the time and no one is pulling them into dark rooms to yell at them. Yesterday, Dave Gleason and his crew were talking to that empty spacesuit and laughing their heads off.
We're letting you off with a warning, Mr. Langston. But this is going on your record, so one more screw up and our next chat won't be so friendly.
Great. That is just great to hear, guys. Thank you. Thank you so much. Hey, is there any chance I could get my copy of The Creator's Dilemma back?
Get out.
Arcade machines. Shoom. Shim. Shoom. Whatever.
Ah.
Games are so realistic these days.
Investigations.
Jesus, don't scare me like that, Winston.
If you're talking right now, I can't hear you. It's a one-way system. Try to find an intercom.
Winston, it's me, Jesse.
I know. I can see you on the monitors. The cameras in there haven't worked since we sealed that sector off a couple years back.
Let me guess. You sealed it because of the monster guy.
Wait, did you see Dr. Hartman? Jesus, I really wish you hadn't opened that firebreak. Okay, listen, you need to find Hartman and kill him before he gets out into the Bureau.
That thing is a person?
He was a person. We brought him here to study after he was, altered in an AWE. I forget the medical word for what happened, but now light physically hurts him. Do you have a flashlight?
No.
A lantern? Headlamp? Oh, yeah, flare gun. Oh, Christmas lights. You could wrap them around your...
I don't have any of those, Langston.
Shit. Okay, well, I'm sure you'll think of something. I'll keep an eye on you from the Panopticon. This is kind of exciting, right?
Maybe from where you're standing.
Right, okay. Well, break a leg. Oh, why did I say that?
Okay. This Hartman thing can't have gotten very far. Let's go flush him out. Langston was right. This is kind of exciting.
It's just nice to have someone to talk to, you know? Ever since I got put in charge of the Panopticon, people treat me different, like I'm crazy for wanting to work with altered items. People just don't understand the altered items like I do, you know? I don't want to brag, but it does take a very empathetic mind to connect with the items.
Doesn't Still, want to brag. Right.
I mean, the teams in research handle paranatural materials every day, and no one thinks they're weird. Well, maybe that's not true. Darling is famous for being a bit out there, but when he's weird, it's charming. Altered items really aren't that frightening once you get to know them. If you figure out what they like or don't like, you know, what sets them off, then there's nothing to worry about. I guess at the end of the day, we're still just wild animals scared of our own shadows. We're supposed to be on the same team, but sometimes it feels like it's every department for themselves, like it's a race and we're all trying to be number one. If it is a race, though, I'd say Darling is a mile ahead of everyone else. He was Trench's golden boy for years, but that relationship has gotten pretty tense, or so I've heard through the grapevine. Not that I spread rumors, just, you know, people talk. Not me, though. I keep my nose to the grind. Too much work to do to focus on those kinds of things. I need to stay focused so I can get my work done and get home to feed Alfred.
He's
of course,
just gonna talk forever,
can't always
isn't
make
he?
It home for mealtime, so I have my neighbor check in on Alfred at 7 o'clock if I'm not back yet. She's very cute. Her name is Maria. Make it home for mealtime, so I have my neighbor check in on Alfred at 7 o'clock if I'm not back yet. She's very nice. Her name is Maria. She's older. She came to New York in the 50s to attend school. She's been here ever since. She has a couple of kids. I met them at Thanksgiving. Big family. Very nice people. Anyway, she has a key to my apartment, and she gives Alfred his dinner if I'm not home. I'm gonna have to buy her a nice food arrangement as a thank you. I'm missing a lot of Alfred's mealtimes. She's probably gonna have to go to the store for more wet food. I'll have to remember to pay her back. Hold on, let me make a note. Pay back Maria for Alfred's food. Okay. Oh, one more thing. And by
Was this what you had in mind? Hartman thing? Do all this?
Reminder, the law of three also applies to all faucets within the oldest house. Be mindful and don't cause any aquatic misconduct. Thank you for your attention.
Lots of dark corners to hide in. Okay, let's get the lights on and clear him out.
afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome aboard the Eagle Limited bound for Chicago. Please have your tickets ready and enjoy the ride.
Good evening, all you fine-looking folks. Here's some smooth tunes to ease your minds and please your ears as we wait for that delicious dinner to roll right on in.
Next stops, Alton, Carlinville, and Springfield. That's Alton, Carlinville, and Springfield. Tickets, please. Tickets. Oh, my God. Fire! Fire! Everyone, stay in your seat. In your seat! Nothing to concern. Sit down.
Fine-looking folks. Here's some smooth tunes to ease your mind.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome aboard the Eagle Limited bound for Chicago. Please have your tickets ready and enjoy the ride.
Next stops, Alton, Carlinville, and Springfield.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome aboard the Eagle Limited bound for Chicago. Please have your tickets ready and enjoy the ride.
Good evening, all you fine-looking folks. Here's some smooth tunes to ease your minds and please your ears as we wait for that delicious dinner to roll right on in.
That was chaotic. Felt like it was trying to tell me something. I wonder if I can make sense of it.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome aboard the Eagle Limited bound for Chicago. Please have your tickets ready and enjoy the ride.
Next stops, Alton, Carlinville, and Springfield. That's Alton, Carlinville, and Springfield. Tickets, please.
Good
tickets.
Evening, all you fine-looking folks. Here's some smooth tunes to ease your minds and please your ears as we wait for that delicious dinner to roll right on in.
Excuse me, ma'am. Do you have a ticket?
You had a pretty dark ride, huh? But I hope you're done replaying it now. Thank you.
someone to talk to, you know? Ever since I got put in charge of the Panopticon, people treat me different, like I'm crazy for wanting to work with altered items. People just don't understand the altered items like I do, you know? I don't want to brag, but it does take a very empathetic mind to connect with the items.
Still, I don't know why people are making it so personal. Right.
I mean, the team's in research. I mean, the teams in research handle paranatural materials every day, and no one thinks they're weird. Well, maybe that's not true. Darling is famous for being a bit out there, but when he's weird, it's charming. Altered items really aren't that frightening once you get to know them. If you figure out what they like or don't like, you know, what sets them off, then there's nothing to worry about. I guess at the end of the day, we're still just wild animals scared of our own shadows. We're supposed to be on the same team, but sometimes it feels like it's every department for themselves, like it's a race and we're all trying to be number one. If it is a race though, I'd say Darling is a mile ahead of everyone else. He was Trench's golden boy for years, but that relationship has gotten pretty tense, or so I've heard through the grapevine. Not that I spread rumors, just, you know. People talk. Not me, though. I keep my nose to the grind. Too much work to do to focus on those kinds of things. I need to stay focused so I can get my work done and get home to feed Alfred.
He's just gonna talk forever, isn't he?
I always make it home for mealtime, so I have my neighbor check in on Alfred at 7 o'clock if I'm not back yet. She's very nice. Her name is Maria. She's old.
Here to fight this. Okay, we're gonna try this one more time and then we're done playing with you.
Understand.
Jelly, where are you from?
Jumbo Brain. Up and loose and heavy treat sandwich.
Jesus Christ, does anyone have any idea what this thing is saying?
Hotly. Derp arrange you.
Why are you here? What the hell do you want? Why'd you stow away on that ship?
School bearing boy boy. Eyes many cauterizing loops through and about. Windy Mitchell.
Did he just say Mitchell? Was there a Mitchell at NASA?
Tubes.
You know what? Never mind. I can't do this anymore. Just send this thing to the guys in research. Let them cut it up or whatever they do. You hear that? They're gonna cut you up, you pain in the ass.
Spider time!
say, I'm just going to freestyle a bit. My mother always said, never talk to strangers.
Looks like whatever force had a hold on Hartman isn't mixing well with his corruption.
Always.
Lake did call him the third thing.
But isn't a stranger just someone you don't know? What if the only thing stopping a stranger from being a friend is that word? Stranger. Strange-er. Strange like the noises you hear at night when there is no light and you cannot fight. Strange like a rubber duck that follows you around and makes you drop your coffee every time that it quacks because the noise scares you. Then you have to clean up the coffee while the duck stares at you and continues to quack. 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 Quack.
A chain letter. I remember these. Mom used to say they were evil. Better do what it says. You know, just in case. There must be a photocopier around here. This certainly feels familiar. one scent.
Thank you.
Two down, one to go. And that's three. That should take care of any bad karma, or whatever. But how did that first letter get in here? I wonder if I could track it to the source. I guess I should just follow the tube. So you're the one sending out spam mail. And that takes care of that. No more superstitious blackmail.
This is Director Faden. Send a ranger to my position.
Let's put him down!
Thank you.
There. One less place for him to hide.
Yes, hello? Yes, me? Worry who? See this-
Hello?
Hello! Great about us today. Long roads and no hardly. You are Bygone?
Sure. Why are you locked up in here?
Casual turning. Back in front. And Gerbil took the top head. Not being pressed for that. Lady going and loosing back for I?
Sorry, I think I'm misunderstanding you. What do you want?
The head? The head for tails? For reading news, jars, words, and tumble. The reading head.
Okay. Take it easy. I'll take a look.
So, maybe it wants something to read. Or a jar. Let's just see what we can find.
Thank you.
could be what it wants. Let's give it a shot.
And peppers? Head!
Okay, that wasn't right. Let's try something else. Maybe it'll like this.
Head. A. S. B. E. Head.
Nope. Let's keep trying. Maybe this will do the trick? Guess that wasn't it either. Huh. This might do it. Maybe.
Lady, you are school and dirt for losing.
Keep that up, and I won't help you anymore.
See if this will do it. I'm ready to be done with this.
Hurry, clocks, lady. The head. 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 No snacks. Head is top of all up and down. At the top. The top head.
Wait, does this thing actually mean head? Head is in a body's head? Where the hell am I gonna find that? And how did it lose it? Is that what the prisoner meant? I guess there's only one way to find out.
chicken station. Far tastier. Press any button?
So the helmet is what you're after, huh?
Tubes! Snug and grape. Pure grapes. Hail a lady.
You're welcome, I guess. Did Kirkland lock you up in here?
Chief Trouble? Yes. Teddy's long around. But holdouts and happiest. Can gather for goldfishes. No wrinkle.
Okay. Well, sounds like you're doing fine in there now. Just make sure you don't go anywhere.
Jelly.
At least we helped this guy. I think. Best we leave it locked up, though. We have no idea what it is, and we don't need any more problems out here.
He was hideous. He tore the security door into the Break Falls AWE site wide open. He was so ugly. Like, wow, I got a good look at him, and Christ, he does not look like he used to. The hiss must have messed him up or something. He looks like a bar rag that's been twisted by the world's strongest man. Or a monster from some 80s horror movie. You know, back when it was all practical effects? Ugh, nasty.
Real.
Did you say something? Remember, I can't hear you. Never mind, just go after Hartman. Ah, so disgusting.
I've written, rewritten. The darkness wants to hide the past and make me lose my way. I trust what I read on these pages. I wrote them for a reason. Cut through the reality, tear it apart, and rewrite it. They are drawn to the mystery. Written and rewritten, deconstructed, reconstructed, experimented with different voices, changed the style, changed myself, forgotten the language, relearned the language. Have I been here before? Gone down this path before? The darkness wants to hide the past to make me lose my way. You must know where you've been to know where you're going. I trust what I read on these pages. I wrote them for a reason. My notes to myself. The only way to make progress, recap, then write more. The style then, lose the fat, make it clear, ugly, functional, present, be blunt. Only the brutal truth, cut through the reality, tear it apart, rewrite it. be clever. Make them do the work. Form the image in their minds. They make it, you just imply. Incept. They're drawn to the mystery, obsessed. You set it up, they put it together. Their interpretation, and there's only one because you give them no choice. And they believe in it because it's theirs now.
Thank you for meeting with us again, Dr. Hartman.
It's my pleasure, gentlemen. I hope the information I provided thus far has been of some small use.
It's been invaluable, Doctor. Really, we have a much clearer picture of this event, thanks to your accounts.
Well, I do consider myself a keen observer of...
We did have one question, though. You mentioned in an earlier conversation that your patients displayed, and I'm paraphrasing here, unnatural abilities that you in fact encouraged during their time in your lodge. It'd be very helpful if you could fill us in on the details there.
Of course. Like yourselves, I work to understand and even bend the rules of our earthly paradigm. My patient's well-being was paramount, of course, but I would hardly be a man of science if I did not reach out at the underlying truth. As I stated in my written proposal, I believe working alongside your organization could be greatly beneficial to both parties. Sharing notes, as they say.
Thank you, Doctor. That's all we need to hear. Remy?
Dr. Emil Hartman, you have been found in breach of codes 4, 8, and 74 of the Federal Bureau of Control Criminal Offense System.
What? You can't do this? I am a well-connected man. You're making a dire mistake, my friend.
You will be detained until further notice and all personal property will be confiscated, including the Cauldron Lake Lodge.
That's preposterous. You can't just seize my property. I'm a United States citizen. I have rights. That lodge is my life's work. I'm offering you years of research.
Get him out of here.
You're making a mistake. You have to listen to me. You have to listen.
Forgotten again. I had a plan. I know it. I've forgotten.
Whatever is going on with Wake, he clearly needs some help.
Mad. Wake had to escape, right? His escape. Wake needed a hero. A hero needed a crisis. For the part in the story about the government agency, Wake needed something special, something to convey an alien force mimicking human intelligence.
Thank you for...
The story needed many beginnings, many springs, streams that turned into a river, a flood, and then an ocean. This was one. Wake used the materials he had, the connections he had, the people, the places. Wake put them in to make it true. His wife, the psychiatrist, his city. These connections, like magnets, move things. Alice was a conduit. She'd been in the dark place. The thing that had been Hartman sensed her near, sensed Wake through her. Went berserk. Broke loose. Wake made sure Alice was already gone by then. Safe. The more springs, the more the story became real. The more people believed. Cause and effect. It was extremely delicate and hard work. It had to go through the path of least resistance where success was most likely, where there was a connection already. Wake felt the pressure grow in his head, going mad. Wake had to escape. Right. His escape. He was already out. He wanted to make it true. Wake needed a hero. A hero needed a crisis. For the part in the story about the government agency, Wake needed something special, something to convey an alien force mimicking human intelligence. Something that can't be translated. Translated. Wake channeled Burroughs and Bowie. He cut up sentences and words, orange peel, You are home. Insane. He put them in a shoebox. He pulled out the words. We created a Dadaist poem. He'd try anything once. Or had he tried this before?
Another replica. Like the one they made for Ordinary. I wonder what happened here.
Send a ranger to my location.
Let's put him down!
These are the notes of Dr. Emil Hartman. I am continuing my work alone again since certain parties were too blind to recognize a golden opportunity. Despite my generous offers, the conversations came to naught. Some people simply do not value collaboration as I do. Though I believe now that it was for the best. The sort of bold pioneering work that I am undertaking cannot thrive under the shackles of bureaucracy and regulation. I have a history of seeking such partnerships. There was a time when I hoped Alan Wake and I could collaborate. Together we could have produced art such that the world has never seen. Wake was stubborn, egotistic. Writers usually are. Disappointing nonetheless. Now, like Tom before him, Wake has disappeared in Cauldron Lake. And this is where my work turns hypothetical. Since he was lost to the lake, Thomas Zane has been observed by various towns. This indicates to me that the individuals within the lake are not entirely gone. I anticipate Wake will similarly return. I may harbor some resentment. His raw talent and determination are undeniable. From this, I have concluded that the lake and the Adar tanks within it are not as removed from this world as I previously thought. Given my acute awareness of what awaits within, my meticulous preparations, and my considerable education, I believe myself much more prepared than either Tom or Wake. I should be able to cross into that dark realm, a chance to return as they have. All that remains is the dive itself. It frightens me, I admit, but such is the burden of the truth seeker. I will take my plunge into the dark tomorrow with only the light of knowledge to guide me. It is time for a breakthrough. Until I return.
Oh!
send a ranger to my location?
Nice to see a director out in the field.
Hartman won't be a problem anymore, Langston. But investigations need someone to run it. Interested?
I've seen what happens to sector heads, ma'am. No, thank you. Ma'am, I'm getting something on my terminal here, an AWE alert from Bright Falls, Washington. But it might be a glitch. The date's all wrong, a couple of years in the future. And we're in lockdown, there shouldn't be any incoming signals.
Maybe it was active before we went into lockdown? Are there agents on site?
Let me check. Agent Estevez is the field agent in charge of monitoring the site, so she should be there to let us know if the situation has been through any major changes recently.
Set in motion. If the alarm's true, then so is the reason for the alarm. The effect must follow the cause. It's happening again. A return. You have been warned.
This must be where they studied Hartman. Kinda looks like Dylan's cell. I wonder if they treated him as badly.
Director Faden here. Send backup to my location. Hi, Jesse. Well, I've got a bureau to run. See you soon.
Yes, ma'am, Director Faden.
Please, Emily. Not even as a joke.